This video was made possible by EA Game Changers.
Hello, my darlings. Welcome to this very special video. I think you guys know, probably from the title, what I have been and gone and done. It's true, I have built two lots for the new Sims 4 Cottage Living expansion pack. I was so excited to receive an email from the Sims team asking me, this was many months ago, by the way, asking me if I would be interested in building some lots for the latest expansion pack. And obviously the answer to that was, hell yes, I am ready, I'm willing, and I am able. I had no idea what this expansion pack was going to be, what it will entail, but I've spent a few months now with some other creators planning and building the lots for this latest expansion. Now, this is a game I've played since the very beginning. Did I ever think one day my own builds will be in an expansion pack to be played in around the world by you amazing people? No, no, I did not. And yet, here we are. This is what is going to be happening. I couldn't believe it. I couldn't believe I had this opportunity to do so. And I can't believe the amount of work that goes in to making these packs. I always knew that the devs worked hard, but I didn't realize what goes into it. The team behind it are just incredible. It was so enlightening and amazing to work with them these past few months on Zoom calls, like going over each of our builds and stuff. And I've just got a newfound love for the dev team more than I did before. So what I'm going to do today is take you on a little tour around the kind of finished product of what I came up with towards the end. There were lots of changes over time. And I didn't record any of the build footage itself. I didn't do any speed build footage. Main reasons being, I just wanted to put my heart and soul into this without having the worry of recording stuff for content. I just wanted to go feet first into this and have a good time without having that worry of, oh, I need to record this and do this. And just, I just wanted to put my all into this. And then I thought, what I can do for my lovely community is kind of show what the outcome was afterwards. I just want to thank EA for this opportunity to do this because it's a dream come true. And I know many of you out there were guessing what my secret project was. Well, you all knew what it was. It was this. And I've had the absolute time of my life doing this. I really have. So enough whiffling on. I think what we'll do is go into the map view first. We'll do a little overview of the map. And then I'm going to take you to the two lots that I've built and we're going to have a little tour around it. So without further ado, let's get simming. So my loves, here we are at a very early version of the world view. So this is the map that you're seeing. Do not be off put at the fact that there's houses sitting on it wonkily. This is a very early version of the map. And I don't even know what this world is called. I don't know what the final name of the world is yet, but it is based very heavily on the Cotswolds, which is an area in England that has got beautiful countrysides, gorgeous villages, lovely little forests. So that is the theme of this overall pack. It's that very countryside village-esque theme that they went for. And when I learned that fact, I was so bloody excited to get building. I really, really was. There were three other creators building lots in this world too. We got the lovely Harry, the lovely Thomas TV, and the lovely Claire Chavon as well, who all had lots themselves. So obviously go and check out their videos and they will talk you through and show you what they built as well. But for me, I'd had two lots, one of them being this little one down here, which is the Gnome's Arms, which is an English pub in the village area. I absolutely loved building this lot. I really did. And the fact that they let us brainstorm for the name of the pub and they all came up with the Gnome's Arms at the end. And I just thought that was a really, really cool name for the pub itself. So I will take you to that one in just a minute. And then I also built this one here, which is in the kind of countryside area. This one is called the Watson Family Farm. I had a 64 by 64 lot to build. When I say I was nervous, I was nervous. I was nervous at the fact that I was going to have to build a 64 by 64 lot without move objects, without any kind of alt placement in an expansion pack for The Sims 4. And did I struggle? Yes. Yes, I did. I did struggle quite a lot. And this was the lot that kind of went under the most changes between the two that I did. But I still bloody enjoy doing it. I really, really enjoyed doing it. And I was really, really happy with the outcome as well. Now, I do not know hardly anything about most of the gameplay stuff that's gone into this. Main reasons being, I wanted to be surprised myself. I know a few aspects of it, but I'm not going to go into too much detail with the actual gameplay in this pack. Just know it's got animals in it, including cows and chickens, and llamas, may I just say. So I think you guys are going to be very excited about that. I know I was when I learned that fact. What I'm going to do today is just go around the lots that I've built and just show you what I did, what I was thinking, things I had to change, and just give you an overall idea of what I did throughout this whole process that has taken a few months now and a few sleepless nights. I won't lie to you, it's just a Sims 4 build, but this meant so much to me. I was just like, I need to get this right. So that is what we're going to do now. I think what we'll do, we'll flop on over to the Gnome's Arms first. And I'm going to show you the pub that I built in The Sims 4, Cottage Living. And here she is. This is the Gnome's Arms. This is in the kind of village area of this world. I'm going to give you a quick peek at the village over that side there. So many good things, market stalls, all sorts, but I'm not going to go into that too much. I want you guys to be surprised with the gameplay. I'm just going to go give you an overview of my build. This is the Gnome's Arms. It is a village pub. Definitely been here for many, many years. Look at this beautiful thatched roof. We've got these objects now, guys, that you can put on top of the build and they make it look like a beautiful little thatched roof. I'm absolutely for it. Absolutely for it. And look at this. Look at this. We've got a telephone box in the game now. We've got a red telephone box in the game that I couldn't wait for. We didn't have this when we first got the build to play with. So I actually built my own until I could put a real one there. And I just think it fits perfectly in this little pub area. So this is the Gnome's Arms, my love. So you can go all around this way. It's got a little beer garden out the back here, which I'm absolutely for. Couple of picnic benches going on there. Little bench. Around the back area here, it's just got a little seating area. A little garden with all these little gnomes coming out. Now, I will say there is a pub sign coming, but I don't know when it is coming. And it's actually got a beautiful little picture of a muscly gnome. I mean, I'm for that. I really, really am. And we haven't got that yet, so I couldn't put it into the game just yet either. But I just love how this came out. I thought it fit really well into the area itself. And this area is so pretty, so beautiful. And you're going to be surprised at a few of the characters coming through, including Mrs. Crumplebottom. Not going to say anything more than that. I didn't have to change too much of this build, unlike my 64x64 lot. That one went under quite a few changes throughout this whole process. But this one here, just kind of, I'm used to a pub. I live in the English countryside, so I'm around these kind of builds quite often. So I kind of had an inkling on what I wanted to go for with this one. And this was the outcome of it. And I love it. I think it's really, really cute. And I'm very much for it. I'm very much in. So this is the interiors. So you kind of coming through this entrance here. Coming through that entrance. This is the main bar area here, complete with the new bar that they've got, which I love, and the new bar stools too. And we didn't have this asset in the game when I first built this, so I had to kind of like use a base game one that wasn't really looking too good with the actual build itself. But as soon as it came out, I flopped it in and I was just like, that's perfect. It looks so good in the game. And I absolutely love this object. It's so, so cute, especially with the little keg on the top there for it. You come over to here. And this is a kitchen. This is a little kitchen. I really wanted to have a kitchen in this pub because if you're British, you know, there is nothing quite like a pub lunch. And I thought, do you know what? I want to get a kitchen in this build because it needs to kind of make sense. If it's a British pub, 9 times out of 10, will have a kitchen in it to serve pub lunches. And I remember a few of the devs were like, oh, we're not sure if the kitchen is... They weren't against it or anything, but they were just like, for gameplay purposes, we were unsure if a kitchen would work in here and stuff. But I was like, no, do you know what? British pubs do have kitchens because pub lunches and whatnot. And I didn't fight for it. They were like, are you sure that you want it in? And they kind of let the others vote on it as well. And everyone kind of agreed that I think it would be a place to have a nice little small commercial kitchen in. So I did a little kitchen. And I mean, it could be quite useful for gameplay as well. Say you had a wedding arch at the back here. You could have your Sims in this as a wedding venue and have this as where the caterers go to cook the food for the wedding, I'm for that. And that happens quite a lot. People do have their kind of receptions in pubs in England. I mean, I would for a start. So this is the kind of like little area where you come in and have a little pub lunch, sit down, have a meal. And this one here is a bit more of a chilled out, relaxed area. Imagine this place with seasons in the snow. I cannot wait to see that. I have not yet seen that. I just think this will look so cute at Christmas with the fire roaring, sitting down, having a bevy with your friends. Absolutely for that storyline. I really am. So upstairs, I have to say one thing first off, ignore the trims that are poking through. They won't be there once this build is actually shipped. There is a bug in the game that the devs are looking into to get rid of that. So don't you worry about that, my darlings. That is going to be absolutely fixed. So up into the next level, I wanted another fireplace up here where a couple of Sims could come up, have a little romantic drink. And there's this little like lounging area with a TV. Usually that does happen in an English pub anyway. Usually the TV though would be kind of like downstairs and all of the sports fans would be sat around watching football or darts or snooker, whatever. But I was like, now, do you know what? I'm going to put it upstairs along with two of the toilets as well, because we all know what it's like, especially if you go to a Wetherspoons in the UK, you have to go upstairs or down into a dungeon or through mountains and a 9-mile hike to get to the toilets. So that is exactly what I wanted to portray in this build itself. But I loved building this. And I think you guys are going to have so much fun in gameplay with this actual bar or pub. Sorry, it's definitely a pub. This is the little back area as well. I did want a little exit out from this way so they could get out this way along to the canals. I'm just for it. I had so much fun building this. I had so much fun playing around with all the new objects once they actually came in. And I'm just really happy with the outcome. So I really hope that you guys enjoy this. I really, really do. And I cannot wait to see what you guys do with this and two plays of it. And remember to tweet me with pictures and stuff when you do get this expansion, if you get this expansion, and show me what your Sims are up to, because I would love to see. I would really, really love to see it. So I think without further ado, you've seen the gnome's arms now. What I'm going to do now is fly on over to the countryside area, and I'm going to show you the Watson family farm. Here she is. This is the Watson family farm. This is a big house. It kept getting bigger and bigger and changing all the way through, and I'm so happy with the outcome after I'd finished. Now, again, this might change slightly because the Sims do need to make sure that this will run well on low-end PCs. They have checked it. There were a few items that needed to be changed. But just, I want to say, things might change slightly to what you're seeing now. And that goes for both builds. The environment artist will get hold of it at the end and make sure it's well optimized for the actual release of the expansion. But this, my loves, is the Watson family farm. Home to the Watsons, but I'm going to let you discover the Watsons for yourselves and sort of see their lore. But I had so much fun building this. So this is obviously the front garden area of the build. This changed quite a lot throughout. I really wanted to make it look like a very English country garden where it was very kind of like organic. And it went through several changes until I was happy with this final outcome, using all of these beautiful flowers, including the new wisteria, which we did fight for. We didn't really fight for it, but we noticed this around the world and we were like, I was like, are we getting any wall climbers or anything? And they were like, we're thinking about making the wisteria in the build catalog, but we're unsure yet. And we were like, please. Everyone was like, we need it. And this is in game now. So you're going to have some beautiful wisteria flopped around your game for you, darlings. And I think you're going to be absolutely made up with it once you do get it. I just think it looks so pretty and I'm not going to ruin it. You're going to go and discover that for yourselves. But this is the family farm. It's got a little walled courtyard area as well that I put into it, just so it's got a little area where your Sims could come out and have a little bit of food on the table there under the pergola, away from the British rain, which you can probably imagine would happen quite a lot with this build. And then it's got access out into the back garden area, but I'm not going to show you that area just yet. We're going to keep that as a surprise. This little walkway here, I wanted a little walkway just around here with a little picnic area where your Sims could come out and actually have a picnic. There is a picnic basket in game now, which is so cute. I absolutely loved that. Over to this side, there's another walkway around this side here as well. Oh, what's that there? I will show you in just a second. So your Sims can come through here. Children can kind of come over here and play on the little climbing frame area. And the parents can sit idly by in the English summer and watch them play. And then there's an entrance going in there. I'll show you that in just a second. And then there's like a little gardening room in there, what I put. Now, over towards the backyard area, I'll show you the big overall picture of the backyard area. This changed so much throughout the whole process. The dev team kept coming back. Can we just change this slightly? How would you feel about this? Would you mind doing... I love that they did that. They kind of gave you free rein to do what you want. And they kind of came back with like really nice critiques. You know, they're all lovely in The Sims team. Wouldn't you think this would look better like this? And the more that they open your eyes to things like that, the more you think, oh, actually, no, it would. It would look much better doing it that way. So that is what happened back here. And I'm so pleased with the final outcome and what happened. But this is a little chicken coop, my love. You can have chickens. You can have eggs. I'm not going to go too far into that. But that is the little chicken coop area here. And I made sure they had a nice little walk space going in there too. And this is an animal barn where you can have cows and llamas. Which I love. I absolutely love it. We didn't get this object until quite late on into the build process either, but I love it. I've yet to see it in gameplay. I have not played any of the gameplay. Main reasons being I don't want to be spoiled for myself. I want to delve into this pack when it releases just as you guys are. So I have not seen this in action yet, but I know it's going to be very, very cute. And I'm not going to spoil it for you guys either. So I don't know what the cows are going to entail. I don't know what you're going to do with them. I think it's going to be amazing. And I cannot wait to see it. I cannot wait to see that in action. I really can't. Now, what is this you say? Is that a pond? Do we have pond tools in the game now? Yes. Yes, we do. And you probably noticed this when I was coming into the backyard area and thinking, what is that? Do we have pond tools now? And yes. Yes, we do. You need to ignore these. These are just placeholders for stuff that you want to spawn on your pond area. I think that's how it works. I'm not too sure. So I've obviously had ducks and dragonflies to swarm around this area in gameplay. You guys are going to absolutely love playing around with the pond tool. It's really, really intuitive. So your Sims obviously can fish. They just come and fish off of the edge into the pond, like normal, into the other world ponds. But you can actually create them yourself. So I really wanted to create my own pond for this place. And I thought it really, really fit in. So this is the back of the build as well. Very nice, long English country farmhouse. You notice this a lot in English country farmhouses. They're quite long. Some of them, anyway, the ones that I know, the ones that are around me. So I wanted to portray that in this build. And that is what I came up with, the shape there. Now, this little area here is a farming area. You get these little pieces and you can actually plant and farm your own veg like normal. And I'm unsure at how these work as well. So I'm not going to go into that too heavily. And I had more of these, but I had to reduce them just for player, like for optimization and for to let the game run a little bit smoother. So I did. I reduced them down into 9 and I had a lot more, but I still think it looks really cute. And I'm really, really happy. I'm really, really happy with how this came out. Little decking area going over here as well, where your Sims can come and sit out as well. Absolutely for that, with a little barbecue area. I just think it's cute. I cannot wait to play around with this in gameplay properly. Really, really cannot wait. So yes, this is the exterior of the Watson family farm, and I just love how it came out. I hope you guys like it as well. Let me know down in the comments. I'd be so interested to know what you guys think of this. But without further ado, let's go into the interiors, darling. So I'm going to show you downstairs first. So this is obviously the entrance hall here. Using flagstone on the floor. I notice with a lot of English farmhouses that I've been in and that I know, they always have flagstone flooring. So I use the base game one all throughout. And this is the kitchen area in here, using the brand new kitchen that comes with this expansion pack. Really, really cute kitchen, including that sink. Look how gorgeous that sink is. And the new fridge. It's a very Smeg looking fridge that I absolutely love, including these new fireplaces as well. New tables, new chairs, new little unit going on there. All in all, I just love how this kitchen came out. And then it's got access out onto the courtyard itself through it that way. But yes, gorgeous. So you come into this little entrance hall and there's a little corridor coming off here. Big toilet and bathroom downstairs with a shower. It's got a lovely dining room on this side too, using the new chairs, obviously, obviously, of course. No, obviously we were only allowed to use base game and the new expansion pack itself. So that was hard to try for me. No move objects, like no packs of any kind apart from two. This was a challenge, but I think that I pulled through and I think I'm happy with the actual outcome itself. So this goes back into the main sitting area itself. So we've got this lovely big sitting room in here with a big log burner off to this side here with these lovely Chesterfield couches that are new to the game as well, as is this console table over there too. And back of the living room over here, I really wanted to have like a little sun moment. So I made a little conservatory off to the side here where your Sims could kind of come and sit in these chairs and read a book or listen to some music and just have the sun on their face, with a little office moment off to the side here as well, which I just love. I love the layout. I love the floor plan. This had to change so much throughout the process. This was a lot smaller. I had to keep making it bigger and bigger. The Sims team were like, bigger, bigger. So I did it each time and I'm happy with the outcome and so were the devs as well. I just hope you guys are happy with it too. So this is the little garden room that I did as well. I wanted a little area where your Sims could look like they could come and do some gardening. This is one of the new objects as well. There's no playable interactions with this, I don't think. But I think it looks like the perfect like potting station. I could be wrong, but I do not think that is a playable object. I think it's just a decorative object. And then you access this through the back here as well, which is that side entrance off to the side there. So there are two entrances coming in this way, which I love. I love. And then upstairs, we're going upstairs. Four bedrooms, two big bathrooms. And it's home to a child or two children, a teen and the parents as well. So that's why I expanded out and made the bedrooms a bit bigger and let the kids have their own rooms. In the beginning, they were in one room with a bunk bed, but I was like, oh, if they want the build bigger, let's actually give them separate rooms. And I had room too in this big farmhouse, you know, so I'm going to treat them. And this is the corridor or the landing. Everybody who's in on that joke will know what I mean by that. So this is the landing here coming through all the way. And there's access to each bedroom off of it, obviously. Apart from the ensuite here. This is the ensuite for the parents' bedroom. So this is their parents' own private bathroom. And then all the kids just share this big one here. So we'll start off in the first kid's bedroom. So look at this cute new wallpaper with the little toadstools on. I wanted to make this very whimsical with lots of little animal-like things everywhere, lots of rabbits. There are wild rabbits in the world now as well, guys. So be on the lookout for them. I haven't seen them properly either yet, so I'm excited to see them for myself. This is the parents' bedroom, so this is the master suite. I made sure to get a nice big fireplace in this room as well, and I just think it'd be really cute lying in bed and having a big roaring fire on in those winter months. New wallpaper as well. Love this new wallpaper. I think it's really, really, really nice. This is going to look so nice in like even like Georgian builds and stuff. So I cannot wait to utilize that more, along with these lovely new farmhouse doors that I absolutely adore. I'm so glad that they went for these. And into the parents' ensuite with a his and her sink. I absolutely love it. This new wallpaper as well, which I'm just loving this new wallpaper, and I used that all along the exterior, as with this one down here too, which is another new wallpaper. The kids' bathroom, obviously the same as the parents' bathroom as well. I didn't want to use too many different objects throughout this build, so I did that. This is for the other kid as well. I just wanted to change the colors up in here slightly, so I use a bit more yellows, but you still using that gorgeous whimsical wallpaper with the toadstools and the hazelnuts and stuff on. I think it's so cute. I just like the overall size of this. I like the layout and I like the overall size. And then it expands at the end of the corridor here and it goes into the teen girl's bedroom. Now this room went under multiple changes. So this is a teen girl's bedroom and I just wanted to portray a teen being able to live in here. So I gave them their own laptop and I just like it. I really, really like the final outcome. And I'm really, really happy. Really, really happy with how this build turned out. Really happy. So, yeah, those were my two builds. Those were my two builds for this expansion. I'll show you some of the different lights as well here. I love the way that the sky looks at night in this world. It's so, so pretty. Look at the moon creeping out over there. Oh, I'm for it. Really, really, really love the lighting in this world. Look at that over there. Oh, I'm for it. I think you guys are going to absolutely love delving into this pack. and seeing how everything works. As am I. I cannot wait to see how everything works properly. Yeah, I just can't believe I've got the opportunity to do this. I cannot believe I got the opportunity to build a build, two builds in a Sims 4 expansion pack. And I cannot wait to see what you guys do with this build. As I said in the last build, make sure to tweet some pictures at me of your Sims living here or any developments that you do on this, whether you change the build or whatnot. I would love to see. I really, really would. But so leave me some lovely comments down below, my loves, and let me know what you guys think of the builds, and let me know what you guys think of the actual expansion as well. I'd be very, very interested to hear that. So there we have it, my loves. Thank you so much to the team at Maxis that invited me to create these lots for this expansion pack. It was a dream come true. And if you want to invite me to do any more, then I'm not going to say no, and I won't turn down the opportunity. I really, really won't. So feel free anytime. Thank you. But yeah, in all seriousness, this has been a dream come true for me. It really, really has. I'm so elated, and I can't wait to see what you guys do with this expansion. Let's have some lovely comments down below. Let's discuss, and let's all have a little hype train going, shall we? I'm going to leave this video here, my loves. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you all in my next video. Goodbye.